And when you look at what's going on, and Christman is being blamed for the sewage, the fact is that Baker is the one who started these high-rises. Christman has escalated the process. If you want to know why the sewage system couldn't handle what it was supposed to happen, part of it is because of these growing high-rises, big developers that's happening at the expense of all the communities here in this city. I want to say that Kunjimi captured the news, but Kunjimi was responding to a position of reparations. Kunjimi was responding to a demand for reparations, responding to a demand that the city of St. Petersburg, after committing so many crimes against the black community, after pushing us out of our homes. I grew up in this city. 50 years ago, I was in prison and given a 5-year prison sentence for tearing a mural down, 8-by-10-foot mural that was on the wall of the city hall, the center of power in this city. That mural was torn down during a demonstration for economic development for the black community. That mural was a blatant statement that we are now talking about Kunjimi making. That mural represented the same thing 50 years ago. But you know what? We're worse off today, 50 years later, than we were when that mural was taken down. Listen, when that mural was taken down, there were black businesses in the black community. We didn't get upset because a Walmart was there or not there, because there were black grocery stores there. There were black dry cleaners there. There were black service stations there. There was a black movie theater, black schools, etc. in the black community. But it has been politicians who've destroyed that. And the latest in this process have been Christman and Baker. Yeah. So Kunjimi said some nasty things, but his words, we can say to Baker and Christman, your accents speak so loud, we can't hear a word that you say. Yeah. And their actions have been worse than anything that Kunjimi could say. So Kunjimi called attention. Let me say that we have an opportunity now to unite the city of St. Petersburg as it has never been done before. We can unite this city. And the way we unite is to stop fighting among ourselves and to come together and fight against the big money politicians and the big developers who are pushing all of us out of our city. So Baker and Christman will have their isolated love fest. And that's all it is. It's incestuous as hell. It's incestuous love fest. They can have that. But they are up against the people. This is a people's movement. And more than that, they pretend that they want the people to vote and be involved in the electoral process, but they are lying. It is the participation of people who never were involved in the electoral process now that's got them so upset. Yes. Now they have this little tidy setting, private setting they've had for so long, is being disrupted by the masses. Yes. You talk too loud. Yes. You sound too angry. You raising questions that shouldn't be raised. You raise big ideas when the only thing we want to talk about is little ideas and what have you. It's a new day. Yes. And it's a new day. It's a new day. And the world is changing all around us. It is changing everywhere. And the people are in motion, and the people will crush those who attempt to keep the people from surviving and from moving forward. Yeah. Black people will be free. Yeah. Black people will be free. Yeah. Women will be free. Yeah. Same gender-loving individuals will be free. Yeah. It's a new day. It's a new movement. You've seen their campaigns. We are supposed to be upset because they don't bring anybody to the debates. They're upset because the only ones who are cheering are the people. Yeah. against the people. And the people will move forward despite everything they do to try to keep it from happening. So I just want to express all my appreciation. Thank you, Mayor Neville. Thank you, Councilwoman Akile. We will turn City Hall into to the people's house, as Akile has said. It will be the people's house. I might even stretch it further than that, but I don't want to upset anybody, so I won't. But let's call it the Freedom House. And some people may be tempted to say it in Swahili. All right.